Sophia, and the one you're about to see is entitled Selfish. I wrote it and directed it.
They lent it for Jim.
There's a couple asterisks for foul language, death, sexual situations, substance abuse, and violence.
To cover all bases. Just covering it all.
I don't know why you walk in like she's gonna stop us or something. You know she won't say anything unless we take the good stuff.
Give her a break, Christine. She just got back from work. She's tired.
And we just got back from school, but do you see her giving a crap? School was great, Mom. My dance teacher gave me a solo in the showcase. Aren't you proud of me? I knew you would be. I celebrated my 17th birthday last week. It's the first time I was actually glad you never showed up. Aren't you just the perfect son? Don't you think you should come back? Didn't your mom say he was back at your party? My dad to ask me that question when I was a teenager. How was school? Did you learn anything new? Any friends? He never noticed or cared. I'm sure he must think that I don't notice things. That I don't see all the shit that happens in their lives. That I don't care. I mean, shit, I've never been a good mom. Never really been a good mom. I never said that I didn't care about them. Just. I look at them and I see him. I hate him. But I think that I don't know this. For example, I know that my son is slowly ruining his liver along with his already failing heart because he thinks he's just gonna die anyway, so it doesn't matter. And there's nothing I want to do more. Give him a hug or hold his hand to show him that I see him. I notice. He's got his father's eyes. I also know that my daughter has a penchant for sneaking guys into her room in the middle of the night when she thinks everybody's asleep. I know she must feel like she needs some sort of approval so she looks forward in any way she can find. And I definitely know that my husband has been having an affair for the last 3 years. Something he doesn't even try to hide. He's been banging legal interns since he passed the bar. But just because I'm saying that I notice these things doesn't mean I'm making excuses. Not at all. And I'm not saying that I should have had kids because I definitely shouldn't have. But I do care. I do know this, and I am not a father.
Making him go there for
no,
a case.
No, I don't care that your job is making you go to Seattle, you selfish asshole! Do you not realize that Neil is in the hospital right now?
I know,
I know. Scared
out
of his mind. And
what?
And what? You're gonna leave? You're gonna
be
like,
Mom?
As
much as you want. But there's no goddamn way I'm leaving you in this hospital while I'm gone.
No. No, I'm not going. There's no fucking way. Unlike you, I actually care about Neil. And you damn well know Carol isn't gonna visit him while we're gone. So I'm staying. And since when do you give a crap what happens to us anyways?
There's nothing to guarantee me that you won't throw some sort of party and trash the hell out of my apartment while I'm not here. Who would stop you? Your mother? So no, you're not staying.
Why would I throw a party while
I'm here? I don't want to hear it! I don't! Shut up! You're coming with me and that's fine. Suck it up. Take this to the car.
Tell the man in the black sedan to come up to my apartment.
No, trust me, you can't miss him. He's been waiting outside all week.
So, are we set on a date then?
Yes, but I need you to make it look like a suicide.
Alright, that's fine. I'll just case your apartment for about 2 weeks. If I can get into our schedule and know the perfect time to be.
And we agreed on $20,000, correct?
That's my standard price, yes. I need a name for the target so I can do some background check.
Carol Meddy.
I'm sorry?
Carol Meddy.
As in the daughter of billionaire Richard Warren, Carol Meddy? The woman who became a CEO at 23, Carol Meddy?
She only got that job because of Richard. She couldn't have done it any other way.
Okay, but that's the person you want me to take out.
Yes.
Then the price is more than the original $20,000. She's incredibly high profile.
How much more?
$500,000.
Fine, whatever. I'll be getting more anyway.
And you did all of that without checking if you were in the house?
Well, in his defense, I was at work. I just came in during the call. Either way, he probably would have done it if I was home anyway. Doesn't think I was, but you. Look, I know you probably thought I spiked your drink or something, and I didn't, but this shit's expensive, so drink your coffee.
Do you have a bathroom?
Yeah, down the hall from the left.
Well, it would be well within your right to say no, but could I use it?
Yeah, of course. Things weren't always this awful.
Do you not understand that my job is my job? I do everything for you. I work incredibly hard for the money that I earn.
You live in one of those expensive apartments in New York City.
I know that you don't understand that because you've never had to work a day in your privileged life.
You go to one of the best schools money can buy.
The only way you even work is because you're in your father's company and a job that your father got for you.
And now you want to start acting like a little brat?
Spend all day doing nothing. And you still have billions of dollars that you do not deserve.
And you decide to misbehave, bother me while I'm at work just because you miss me? Now you want to spend more time with me?
And you can't even do the simple task of paying the mortgage. You can't do one singular goddamn thing, huh? I'm sorry, no. I'm not gonna help you just because you can't do anything by yourself.
Sure, kiddo. If that's what you want,
I'm not gonna put
I'll
my
make sure
money
that happens, okay?
He's actually
gonna put your money. You go to public school, you're about living in the street, and if that's what you want, I'll make sure that
I
happens.
I have to work for what I have.
You don't think about anyone by yourself.
You're so useless.
You're
so
goddamn
selfish.
So, would you like me to kill you now?
Can I get a little more time? I'm sorry, I just been coming in. I'm just, I'm really scared.
No, you could. Offer me more money. To kill him, I mean.
That would just screw up my karma even more.
What do you mean?
I've been able to get out of bed for a week. Please let me get rid of this baby when I'm only because I'm miserable.
You'd really be willing to kill a child just because you're too useless to take care of it?
It's not a child yet.
Disgusting.
sorry, but you need to sign for insurance or something. I'm not sure how it works, but a woman works for my dad, so it was all prepaid, and all I had to worry about was coming in. And I didn't realize that.
I'm sorry.
For what?
I'm supposed to be a trained assassin, but I'm weak. I've never killed anybody this close. I usually snipe people from far just to cope with the fact that I'm such a sympathetic person.
Can I do it?
You understand this will go a lot more quick and painless if you just let me do it. If you try anything, shoot me maybe. I will not hesitate to kill you.
Now, why would I try to kill you? Seem like a nice guy.
Oh. In that case.
Mercy Hospital.
Yes, hi, my name is Carol Lennon. I live in the Atelier, which is on 635 West and 42nd Street. My son, Neil Medding, has been in room 113 in the hospital for almost a month. He has been bedridden due to heart complications, yet he is still very low on the transplant list. I am about to commit suicide. Please do not do anything to try and stop me, but I need to make sure that you will do nothing to save me, but make sure that my son gets my heart.
It was nice talking to you, Miss Medding. It was very nice knowing you, Carol Medding.